It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangilawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.
We have one item in public hearing. It's the adoption of TP Ordinance Number 21-11. It's an ordinance to grant a variance to Tangipahoa Parish Code of Ordinances, Chapter 17-4.2-4A, mini partitions for Mr. Eduardo Gato at 41066 Byers Road, Punchatoula, Louisiana, in District 2. Is anyone here to speak on that item? Okay. We'll close public hearing. We'll go into our regular business meeting for the Tangipahoa Parish Council. Call to order. We'll have invocation by Mr. Lewis Joseph with Pledge of Allegiance led by Mr. Trent Forrest.
Thank you.
Mr. Bruno?
Here.
Mr. Bristol?
Here.
Mr. Mayhew?
Here.
Mr. Wells?
Here.
Mr. Vial?
Here.
Ms. Hyde?
Here.
Ms. Coates?
Here.
Hopefully everyone had a chance to look over the minutes that were emailed to you. If we have a motion to accept the minutes from February 8th, 2021 meeting.
I so move, Madam Chair.
Second.
We have a motion by Mr. Wells, second by Mr. Ingrafia. Accept the minutes. Roll call, please.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingrafia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Ristel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Okay. Public input. Is there anyone who would wish to address an item that is not on the agenda for public hearing? Okay. Ms. Downer, we'll have you speak when that item comes up on the agenda, if that's okay. We'll have our parish president come and give us his report now.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
It's nice to be a little warmer. We just have a few items on the agenda for your approval. We have approval of final acceptance of overlay program phase 21 for the fiscal year 2020. Our inspectors have confirmed that all the work has been completed properly and is ready to be to go into the warranty period of work.
Do we need a motion?
I so move.
Second.
So we have a motion by Mr. Rich. Motion by Mr. Original, second by Mr. Wells to approve the final exception of our overlay program, phase 21. Roll call, please.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Thank you. The second item is approval of the new and current model Western Star 4700 roll-off truck bid. There were two bids received. All Truck Parts and Equipment Company, LLC, was the lowest bidder at $162,802. You remember we came to go out for bid, tried to find a used truck, didn't work out, came back. That's like our third attempt to get this truck purchased.
So moved.
I'll second. Okay. I have a motion to accept the bid by Mr. Mayhew, second by Mr. Coates. Roll call, please.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes. Thank you. The third thing is an approval to enter into a memorandum of understanding between Tangipahoa Parish Government and the Tangipahoa Rec District Number 3 to go to apply for a Keep Louisiana Beautiful Trash Receptacle Mini Grant Program.
All right, we have a motion by Mr. Joseph, second by Mr. Forrest. Roll call, please.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
And the last item is just informative. Your financial reports, you should have a copy of one and emailed to you. As always, if you have any questions, please reach out to Jeff or Miss here, any of the staff, and we'll be glad to get you the information.
Good.
And does anybody have any questions for me?
Robbie, can we get an email or a copy of the list of roads we're to overlay?
Yes, sir.
The final.
Okay, the ones that we just did,
yeah.
The finished. Okay,
yeah.
Yes, sir. I'll send that right now. Yes, sir. Any other questions? Great, thank y'all.
Thank you. All right, we'll move into regular business. Item number 5 is adoption of TP Ordinance number 21-11, an ordinance to grant a variance to Tangipahoa Parish Code of Ordinances, Chapter 17-4.2-4A, many petitions for Mr. Eduardo Gato at 41066 Byers Road, Punchatoula, Louisiana, in District 2.
So moved.
Second here.
Mr. VL?
Yeah.
Okay. We have a motion by Mr. Ingraffia, second by Mr. VL. Roll call, please.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Okay. Item number 6 is an introduction of TP Ordinance number 21-12, an ordinance to place a variance to Ordinance number 97-25, adoption of State Sanitary Code, for Randy Legault at 42101 Highway 22 West, Punchatoula, Louisiana, in District 10.
That's Ms. Coates. I'll make that motion.
I'll second.
We have a motion by Ms. Coates, second by Mr. Wells. Roll call, please.
Mr. Richel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. VL?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Ingraffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Okay. Next item is item number 8. I'm sorry, I checked off the wrong one. Item 7, introduction of TP Ordinance Number 2113, an ordinance to place a moratorium on the consideration and or approval of all solar panel farms or commercial solar power plants within Tangipahoa Parish until such time as the pending studies and ordinances are complete.
This was brought by the Regulations Committee. We just want to make sure we have the proper ordinances and everything in place to protect the Tangipahoa Parish residents before we allow those. So this is not saying no, this is just to make sure we have the rules and regulations in place.
What's the time?
Yeah, what's the time?
It should be 90 days.
90 days.
It doesn't say that.
In the ordinance, it does. It's where it says, be it further ordained that the moratorium shall expire 90 days from the adoption.
Oh, in the ordinance?
Yes, sir. In the ordinance.
All right, I got a question about it. It's probably not something I'm happy about, but it's the sign of the towns, and when it comes to personal property, you know, that's a big thing to me, and I think people should be allowed to do what they need to do on their property. But I'd like to ask that we get this along as soon as possible, that we don't drag this thing out 90 days, because I just don't believe there's really a lot that we can do. I think what we need to do is have some protection in there for the landowners as far as what happens at the end of these leases. And I think maybe look at a bond, that these companies put up a bond. But I just don't think we need to drag this out for no long period of time, because some of these people have already signed with these companies. And I don't want to jeopardize anybody that has already signed and has an understanding. But I would like to see us kind of put this on the front burner and try to get this thing done in the next, you know, 2 weeks to 30 days if possible. Because I just don't see where we've got a lot of ammunition to shoot. The only thing we can do is kind of protect them from the couple of things that's there that we know we can do, and then the rest of it, we just got to hope for the better, you know. But that would be all I have to say, because I know quite a few people that are looking at it or either have signed, and you know, it's a personal preference. So I don't know how much we can get ourselves involved in personal property.
All right, Mr. Joseph.
What is the possibility of bringing whomever here to explain to this council what this is all about, so people out in
the... We have a representative from one of the companies here, so
oh,
she's
really?
Going to speak.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry, that's on your toes.
Okay. Ms. May, do you have a comment? If no one else has a comment.
I just have a few.
Okay, Mr.
Bia. I think Ms. Bruno hit the nail on the head. Okay, we want to respect people's property rights, I'll be sure they're protected. You know, there's a lot I don't know about this. I've seen them, unfortunately, and, you know, is it a type of bond you need? Is there some kind of, are there safety studies out there? Sure there are. And we just need more information to really what we're looking for, okay? So I think we need to try to wrap this up as soon as possible myself. But I do think it's in the best interest of the property.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm
well,
sorry.
Ms. Downer had turned in a form to speak. Can we allow anyone out if you'd like to speak? They're on the back table if you'd like to grab one, and we'll, after she speaks, we'll recognize you.
Is this what the kind of clean energy? Do y'all know?
Yeah, well, it's part of it.
Okay.
All right, Ms. Downer.
Hold on to me. Good evening. My name is Laurel Downen, and I am with Invenergy LLC. We are a Chicago-based energy project developer specializing in renewable energy, so clean energy, solar, wind, natural gas, and battery storage. So far, we have developed 175 projects worldwide. We are currently working on the development of a solar farm just down Highway 16 here. And I've read and heard some of your concerns about the project decommissioning and associated environmental risks, so I just wanted to address some of those this evening. First and foremost, the solar panels are primarily made of recyclable materials, so that's glass and steel. We do not use panels that contain heavy metals, so no cadmium, mercury, or lead. We do use panels that contain crystalline silicon, which is a non-hazardous material. Furthermore, Invenergy is committed to using materials which pass the T-clip test, and that's toxicity characteristic leaching procedure. And I'm not an expert in that, but it is the EPA's test to determine the toxicity levels in certain materials. And so we only use panels that have passed that test. In regards to removing the facilities after the life of the project, we typically institute a decommissioning bond while the project is in operation to ensure that we have funds to be able to remove the facilities after the project has finished its life. And lastly, we are required in our leases to restore the land back to its original condition or reasonably similar conditions as they were pre-development. I actually have 10 copies, perfect for of a independent study conducted by NC State that addresses a lot of these issues and just gives really good background information about solar development.
You said that y'all panels do not have heavy metals. In the agreements that you have with the landowners on these leases, is that included in the lease that there's no heavy metals? Because what would happen if y'all put up the non-heavy metal panels and then something changes? I mean, it could be changed to the heavy metal panels.
So I think there's one of the things that I like, that y'all don't use the heavy metals, but I think that needs to be put in there.
For the benefit of the landowners, that we only use a certain type of panel. Because five years down the road, if these don't work, or they find out the other ones are better, what protection is there for the landowner using heavy metal? You know, going from what they thought was going to be not heavy metal. And then I guess the other thing is, you said a bond, that y'all do put a bond. How is that bond valued?
Okay.
And is that a transferable deal in case your company sells to somebody else that transfers with the sale?
Yes.
Is that in agreement?
I'm not positive.
Okay. But see, these are the things that we're concerned about. And really, to tell you the truth, a landowner needs to be concerned about these things. Because companies sell out, they go out of business. Who knows what's going to happen down the road? It might sound good right now, but what is the protection in the long run if that company no longer exists when the shelf life of these are over with? So those are the kind of questions, and I really appreciate you being here. But I would like to see the answers to those questions. Okay.
So there's nothing in your panels that you have to pay to dispose of. They're all profitable recyclable.
Well, one of the things we could require, Trent, we don't want panels with heavy metals. So if that's one of the concerns, you can...
I have that part of the architecture, we need to look at things to make sure that the property owners are protected. And then to make sure that when the company is finished, the land is returned to its property. Those are some of the things that we can do. Do you happen to know what the megawatts is, or do you have any clue? The one down the road, we're working on 120 megawatts. Do you know when y'all were planning on starting construction?
That's the question. We are targeting a commercial operations date of the end of 2023. So that would mean starting construction towards the Q3 of next year.
Is there a website where we can do more digging?
Absolutely. Well, our website is in Venergy, and I'll give you all cards. This report that I brought is, that's just more information about our company. The report that I brought can give you more information about solar panels in general. And there's lots of information on the web. I'm happy to send you more info about these specific items.
Okay.
Do your panels rotate?
Yes, they do, yeah.
What is the life expectancy of these panels? And is there any dangers if any that these panels, you know?
The life expectancy of the solar farm is 35 years. And short answer, no. We see this as renewable energy as a very clean, non-hazardous source of fuel and fuel to the local economy.
Do you typically put buffers around your farms?
Yes, ma'am. In terms of, yeah, setbacks from the roads. Mm-hmm.
Do you have a certain, like a typical size or?
If there's not a statewide or a local ordinance, then I believe our, I believe it's 50 feet from the roads, but I'd have to double check that.
What about like hurricanes, storms? How susceptible are these to damage? Do you have any in areas that, you know, where there have been hurricanes come through, and how do they hold up?
We do not currently have anything in the coastal zone or anything as far south as Louisiana. The panels are rated for different wind categories, and typically the way it works is whoever the customer is. In this case, we have a great relationship with Entergy, so that's who we're working with to try to offtake the project, but we're open to any ideas here. And they request a certain category, like storm category for the strength of the panels.
I got one question. Ms. Laurel, y'all company actually finds the leases, signs the leases. Y'all build the farm.
Yes, sir.
Y'all company builds the farm. And then y'all try to get an agreement with a power company to buy the energy. Is that correct?
That's one of the deal structures we have. That we have a power purchase agreement. We also sometimes do deal transfer agreements where we build it all. And then at panel completion, we transfer the asset that's purchased by utility.
So you would have to actually have a transmission line to be able to get this solar power to whatever power company.
That's correct, yeah.
So have y'all secured the transmission line on this farm?
Yeah, we are in the process of doing that. So there's the chicken farm substation right by the Lincoln Horse Road. And we're going to be connecting into that line right off that substation. The process for getting what they call the GIA interconnection agreement is very long.
Right.
We're expecting the GIA end of this year, but we are currently in the process.
Okay.
Evaluating.
Right.
Are there any other questions? We appreciate you coming, especially this is short notice.
Yeah, thank you all so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Mr. Jay, is that Boss?
Boss. I've been around here many years. I've worked some of y'all, worked with some of y'all. I'm currently residing at 60 Road 5, 3, 4, 5. And I'm aware that they have solar farm come. I was approached by my email to sign on. I did not. And in my words, what I like is my house, where I live, is for me, for my family, and to me. And I do support landowners. I believe that they should use land how they want to do what they want to. But also, you have to imply that they should not impact negatively on nature. Okay. Having said that, chances some of our concerns, especially with heavy metals and harmful chemicals that could get into the ground for many years. Also, how would it affect the water runoff? I live on the side of the hill. Where they want to put solar panels, above the hill. So where will that stormwater run? Another thing is tornadoes and high winds. What about the increase of the metal that's been placed on these lands? Electricity being reduced causes electromagnet. It could increase lightning strikes around, because we are very prone for lightning strikes where we live. I'm almost calling it like exterior microwave. And what about the glare reflection from the panels itself? Do these panels producing radiation, which should be mindful of, you know, you talk about some landowners, they did sign on, and landowners did not sign on, or we won't protect them. What kind of radiation will affect our environment, our wildlife, our human beings from the next door? But my main concern is this: we need to set up some type of boundary between the property line where we're going to put the panels, and then we should have two separate boards, one for the property lines and one for the residents, because where they put the solar panels, it could be on two sides of my house. And my house is more than, on one side is probably 20 feet from the property line, and on the other side maybe 40 feet.
So I would want any type of hazardous waste, water from the panels, radiation, and the glare. I appreciate your time here this evening. Thank you. Move on to item number eight.
Now you have to do this to get the PPP?
Right. We have to go to the bond commission to get approval to do that. And so it's just normal PPP. You don't have to pay for that. It's been 99% forgiven. I mean, we can use this strictly for payroll, not for anything else, so it should all be forgiven. But that is the requirement for the bond commission. Would you say your name? I second.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Beal?
Yes.
Ms. Todd?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest? Mr. Graffia? Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richel?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Wait, wait. I want to ask a question.
Yes.
Item 10, adoption TT resolution number R21-07, a resolution of support for the Tangipahoa Parish Council for KAE, just to keep America beautiful, community enhancement grant program.
In order for us to do our grant from Keep America, we have resolutions for the council. This ties into the resolution I asked for earlier, where the Red Ridge District comes down and draw all the grants on those, either Louisiana or America. We have a support for the whole administration and council. So that's what we're asking.
Second.
Yes.
Mr.
Forrest?
Yes.
Mr.
Graffia?
Yes. Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr.
Yes.
Mr. Richel?
Yes.
Mr.
Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph? Yes. Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr.
Yeah,
I'm just curious where that name comes from, Mr. Joseph.
I'll second.
We have a motion by Mr. Joseph, second by Mr. Dio. Roll call, please.
Mr.
Roll call, please. Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richard?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wellwell?
Yes.
Mr.
BL?
Yes.
Mr. Todd?
Yes.
Mr. Coach?
Yes.
We
are going to
change
the Parish
Water
District. Just one.
That's what I want.
You've got to have all the paperwork, please. Okay. Mr. Wells,
is he here?
No.
Mr.
Williams?
Oh, great,
yeah.
Not expired.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
well, I'm sorry. I messed up on that one. I'll fill them out.
Second.
Second.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr.
Yes.
Richard?
Yes.
Yes.
Joe.
No. You have a second?
I'll second.
Roll call, please. Mr.
Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Mr. Richard?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wellwells?
Yes.
Mr. BL?
Yes.
Mr. Todd?
Yes.
Mr. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Item 14, point reappointing recreation district 3 for the AH area.
Yeah, that's mine.
Second.
We have a motion from Mr. Judges, second by Mr. Wells, to reappoint Gerald Medina and Wayne Johnson. Roll call, please. Mr.
Bruno? Yes.
Mr. Richard?
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. BL?
Yes.
Mr. Todd?
Yes.
Mr. Coates?
Yes.
Mr. Forrest? Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
I really encourage you.
open mind and let's hear what this is.
Madam Chairman, if it's okay with you, I don't give him any false hope, because I'm totally against this. We're elected to represent our constituents. I appreciate these people serve, that their pleasure to do this, but this is not a matter, you know, and I've had a couple of them, you know, I'm with the party, even if something meets its qualifications, turn down, I don't like it. Well, that's not what it's about. You got rules in place that are passed by this council. It's up to them to follow the rules that are passed by the council. And I do know there's a state statute, but also, this parish is under our own charter. It can operate under the rules that we have. And to give away sole authority to allow someone to decide whether a person should build something or not, I'm totally against that. And I just assume tonight, I'll make a motion now, that I don't agree with that. And I think instead of dragging this out, I think it needs to be known that, now, I mean, I'm not going to get out of there, everybody thinks they're different than me, but I'm not going to put this in the hands of somebody that's not elected to make those decisions. Because I can tell you what's happening, we're going to wind up in court about 90% of the time. And we're going to lose. That's my only thing I'm going to say about it.
Well, I expressed my opinion to the board, I sent out an email, so I'll just not belabor all those points, but I'm in the same boat as Mr. Bruno. I'm not going to give this authority. I'm elected by approximately 13,000 people, we all do, okay? So I'm not going to give this authority to, and I appreciate everything the board does, but I'm not going to give it to our planning commission, give them sole authority, I'm not going to do that, okay? And we've already experienced this, okay? The name of the firm was Gulf Coast Cabinetry. And I didn't really like where they were putting Gulf Coast Cabinetry. But like illegal to do different things, and that's what I said that night, okay? They followed every process we had, every regulation we had in the parish, down to the T. Went to the planning commission, and they voted no. Okay? Now, why did they vote no? I understand. They had a number of people who lived next door came and did not like what was going to be built. But liking illegal are two different things. So we've already experienced this once. And I'll second Mr. Bruno's motion. I think we just need to vote on this. And everybody express their opinion.
Regulations, and then you're going to have somebody else to say, well, I know the council voted these regulations, but I don't like them. So I'm going to vote no.
I'm telling you, you're going to be in federal court every time you turn around, and like Wendy said, you're going to lose. Absolutely. But I mean, you're talking about giving away, and it's not a matter of authority. You're the one that has to stop. The people are coming to you. So if you give away your authority, then who are the people going to go to? They're going to go to the planning commission? I don't think so. Your phone's going to keep ringing off the hook. So I'm just telling you. I'm going to make a motion. If it don't get supported, that's fine. I may make a motion that we do not give full authority. And that's my motion.
What do we have the appointees for? If they have to follow the regulations that have had place, right?
Yes.
So why would they turn down? They're going against regulations that have had place.
Well, that's what happened with the county experience.
Right, I mean, why did they turn it down?
But the regulations don't protect against traffic. The regulations don't protect against other things that may not be in the regulations. Like, my project just does not fit a certain community.
We don't have zoning, until you get zoning, you don't do anything like that.
Can we add some more regulations to cover some of those things?
I think regulations are all one thing. You're right. If you see something that needs to be changed, and you get the votes to change it, that's how you do it.
But you don't give that authority to someone that's not elected to change the rules. That's my thinking. Now, I may be totally wrong, but I don't think you're going to see anybody give away their authority to a board that is not elected and doesn't answer anybody to have sole authority of what is constructed in this parish and what's not. That's just my thinking now. Y'all can vote differently, that's up to you, but that's my opinion. I don't think you're taking their vote away.
If they're told they have to vote yes, then...
If the project comes before them, Kim, and it meets the regulations that you passed, why should they? I'm asking, Joy asked that same question. If it meets the regulations that you have on the books, and it is meeting it all 100%, why should they vote against it? Because three or four people are there complaining about it? That's not how it works.
If I'm wrong, y'all tell me I'm wrong, but I don't think it works like that.
I have a motion by Mr. Bruno, second by Ms. Vial. Roll call, please. Mr. Richtel? Yes, vote in favor of your motion, not in favor of this ordinance.
Yes.
Mr. Mayhew?
Yes.
Mr. Wells?
Yes.
Mr. Vial?
Yes.
Ms. Hyde?
No.
Ms. Coates?
No.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Graffia?
Yes.
Mr. Joseph?
Yes.
Mr. Bruno?
Yes.
Beer, wine, liquor, we have one. This is on here. There's two. First is GN Sightseeing Investments, Cash and Dash, 190 River, 9 Sisters Drive, Honolulu.
I think that's Mr. Vial. I think they're both. The second one is Stop and Shop, number 13, 44192, Highway 45, Robert.
These are both Mr. Vials.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Forrest? Mr. Graffia?
Mr. Joseph?
Mr. Bruno?
Mr. Ruschel?
Mr. Mayhew?
Mr. Wells?
Mr. Beal?
Ms. Hyde?
Yes.
Ms. Coates?
Council's privileges.
I have one. Which mother of the area county member is 98 years old.
Right.
You mean you gonna be around that long?
It'll be Wednesday, 12/22. At Ramsey Conference.
There are no other council's privileges. Mr. Wells, would you like to?
Yes, I'll take that. I'm a little bit adjourned.
Motion by Mr. Wells, second by Mr. Beal to adjourn.
I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help. Don't be intimidated by large insurance companies who just want to make your problem go away. We are here to represent your rights and interests. Contact me today at tangilawteam.com and let's get to work.